Derivatives of Polynomials and Natural Exponential Functions, Level 1. In order to find the derivative of polynomials and natural exponential functions without consistently using the definition of the derivative, we need to develop rules that enable us to calculate the derivative with relative ease. Let's start with our first rule, the derivative of a constant function. Recall that the derivative can be geometrically interpreted as the slope of the tangent line to the curve y equals f of x at a given point. If we were to graph a general constant function of the form f of x equals c, where c is a constant, it would look like this. Notice that the constant function is actually a horizontal line. This means that it has no slope. In other words, it has a slope of 0. Since the geometric definition of the derivative is the slope of the tangent line at every given point on the curve, we can conclude that the derivative of a constant function is equal to 0. Alright, let's proceed with our next rule. The second derivative rule is called the power rule. This rule is perfect to take derivatives of power functions of the form f of x equals x raised to the power of n. The rule states that the derivative of a power function whose exponent is n is equal to n times the power function raised to the power of n minus 1. Notice that you have to bring down the exponent and subtract 1 from the original exponent, which then becomes the new exponent of the new function. For example, say that we have the graph f of x equals x. The function is a power function of degree 1. In other words, it's a linear function that passes through the origin, and whose slope of the tangent line at every single point on the curve is equal to 1. This means that the derivative of the function should be equal to 1. Let's use the power rule to show just that. So using the operator d over dx to represent the derivative, we apply it to the function f of x equals x. So we go ahead and apply the power rule. We first bring down 1, and multiply it by x raised to the power of 1 minus 1, which simplifies to x raised to the power of 0. This expression simplifies to 1. So the derivative of f of x equals x is equal to 1. Alright, let's move along to our next rule. The next derivative rule we have in our arsenal is a derivative of a natural exponential function. Let's compute the derivative of a natural exponential function f of x equals e raised to the power of x by using the definition of the derivative. Recall that the definition of the derivative was equal to the following expression. F prime of x equals the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x over h. Using the natural exponential function as our f of x, we go ahead and substitute it into the definition as follows. Next, we go ahead and rewrite this expression as e raised to the power of x times e raised to the power of h by applying the properties of exponents. Next, we go ahead and factor out the common e raised to the power of x term as follows. So now we have e raised to the power of x times the limit as h approaches 0 of the quantity e raised to the power of h minus 1 over h. Notice that we can't just substitute 0 for h, since division by 0 is undefined. So we're going to find this limit in a different way. Notice that this expression does not contain the independent variable x. The only way that this can occur is if the variable x was equal to 0. Recall that any number raised to the power of 0 is equal to 1. This means that this expression is essentially the derivative of the natural exponential function evaluated at x equals 0. As a proof, let's confirm this by finding an expression of the derivative of the natural exponential function, evaluated at x equals 0. Doing that, we have the following. Recall that anything raised to the power of 0 is equal to 1. In the end, we obtain the following expression. Now that we know that this limit represents the derivative at x equals 0, we can substitute this limit with f prime of 0. This way, the final derivative of the natural exponential function is equal to e raised to the power of x times f prime of 0. Recall that we can also interpret the derivative of a function as a rate of change. This expression says that the rate of change of a natural exponential function is proportional to the function itself, where the constant of proportion is equal to f prime of 0. In other words, the slope of the tangent line at x equals 0. So let's take a look at the graph and see if we can find a value for f prime of 0. Here we have a graph of the natural exponential function. Now, in order to compute the derivative, by using the expression we derive, we need to find the tangent line to the curve at x equals 0. That is to say, at the point 0, 1. The tangent line through the point 0, 1 is represented by the green line. So looking at the green line, it looks awfully familiar. It looks like the line y equals x, or f of x equals x. So graphing this line on the graph, we see that the tangent line and the line f of x equals x are actually parallel. This means that both lines have the same slope. The slope on the line f of x equals x is 1, so the slope of this tangent line is also 1. This means that the derivative, or f prime of 0, is equal to 1. Substituting this result to the expression we derived earlier, we conclude that the derivative of a natural exponential function is equal to itself. This is by far one of the easiest derivatives that you can find in calculus. All right, now let's go over a couple of examples and see these rules in action. Let's try the first example. Find the derivative of f of x equals 10. Notice that we are dealing with a constant function, so we need to use the rule for the derivative of a constant function. So applying the rule, we have that the derivative of f of x equals 10 is equal to 0. The derivative of a constant is always equal to 0, because the slope of the tangent line at every given point on the curve is equal to 0. Alright, that was pretty easy. Let's try the next example. Find the derivative of f of x equals x cubed. Notice that we are dealing with a power function of degree 3. So this is a perfect candidate for the power rule. So we go ahead and apply the power rule to the function. Here, the value of n is equal to 3. So we drop down the 3 and multiply it by the function raised to the power of 3 minus 1. Remember, we need to subtract 1 from the exponent. Simplifying the expression, we have that the derivative is equal to 3x squared. Okay, that was also pretty easy. Now let's try one that is slightly more complicated. Find the derivative of f of x equals 1 over x squared. At first, it seems that we can't use any of the rules that we just learned to find a derivative of this function. It turns out that we actually can, but not in its current form. We need to rewrite the function into a derivative-friendly form. Recall from your studies of Algebra 1 that we can rewrite this rational expression as a negative exponent. So we can rewrite this function as x raised to the power of negative 2. This way, we have it in a derivative-friendly form. Now we can apply the power rule. So we bring down the negative 2 and multiply it by x raised to the power of negative 2 minus 1. Notice that we are actually adding two negative numbers, so be careful. Simplifying the expression, we have that the derivative of the function is going to be equal to negative 2 over x cubed. Alright, let's try the next example. Find the derivative of f of x equals the square root of x. Once again, it seems that we don't have a derivative rule that we can use. Just like the previous problem, we need to rewrite this function into a derivative-friendly form. We accomplish this by remembering that radical expressions can be written as fractional powers, as follows. So now we can apply the power rule. So we go ahead and bring down 1 half and multiply it by x raised to the power of 1 half minus 1. I hope you remember how to subtract fractions. This is precisely what we need to do now. The way we subtract or add fractions is to have a common denominator, and then subtract or add the numerators, and keeping the common denominator. So doing that, we have the following expression. So it turns out that the derivative is equal to 1 over 2 times the square root of x. Alright, let's try the last example. Find the derivative of f of x equals e raised to the power of x. If you were paying attention, this is one of the easiest derivatives you can compute in calculus. The derivative of a natural exponential function is just equal to itself. And there you go, we are done. Alright, in our next video, we will learn even more derivative rules to help us compute more complicated derivatives.